Cause when I arrive, I'll bring the fire, make you come alive. I can take you higher, what the sense?
Hi guys, it's Misty, StylingGirl00, and I am finally here with the feather extension video. So I am so sorry that it took me so long to get around to doing this. I've had my feathers, I guess, for about a week or a week and a half, something like that. And my whole plan was to go over to my girlfriend's house and actually do the feather extension on my girlfriend's daughter's hair. That way she could film and get a better angle as I was actually putting the extension in. But that didn't happen. Our schedules never worked out the way we could get together. So, I'm going to try to do this myself, and hopefully you can see what I'm doing. It's really easy. I guess let's just get started, and I'll show you the couple things that you're going to need. I've seen a couple different videos on YouTube. People do this different ways. I had these things in my house other than the cylinders that I had to purchase and the feathers. So, like I said, this is my take on it, the things I use. You can watch the other videos as well and use whatever products that you have in your house or purchase what you need to purchase. So, you're going to need a pair of needle-nose pliers. The feathers that you're going to use, the cylinders, I use a bobby pin and a clip to hold my hair back out of the way. Now the feathers I purchased came 25 in a pack, and they were individual feathers that came like this, 25 different individual feathers. You can get them now, which I have already have an order in now for different colored ones. You can get them where there's 5 or 6 feathers already bonded together into one. So you have like 5 or 6 feathers like this already bonded together at the top and one. You only have to slide one in, clamp it down, and you're done. But I chose to purchase the individual feathers. Now the ones that I have on order are all together in one clump. So hopefully that'll be a little bit easier to put in. You'll see what I'm saying once I actually get into doing it. So anyway, let's just get started and I'll show you what you need to do. Just to show you, I already have some on this side. I need to flat iron my hair so that they'll blend in with my hair a little better because this one's sticking out. I have 2 different ones in. Let's see. And they blend in with my hair, as you can see. They're a caramel and black color. So they don't really show up in my hair in this light, but they do in the light outside. Anyway, my hair is plucking my nerves today. I just did it, washed it, and dried it. So you can see them sticking out down here. And they blend in better once I get my hair done and styled the way that I want it. Anyway, let's just get started. I'm going to put one in on this side. So you want to separate it like this because you want to hide the extension. So what you're going to do is clip this part of your hair out of the way. And then I want to go ahead and get out. These are the little container that the cylinders come in. They actually make these cylinders with silicone in the inside. Sally's didn't have them, so I just purchased the metal ones. They don't have They don't have the silicone lining, but you can get those. They say that it clamps and sticks to your hair better, but I haven't had any problems with mine coming out. You can wash these, dry these, crimp these, curl these, flat iron these, whatever you do to your hair, you can do to these. I've had the ones in on the one side, like I said, for probably about a week and a half, and I haven't had any problems with them coming out. So you're going to take a piece of hair like this, pick it up. Now they make the tool that can feed this through the cylinder, but you know what, a bobby pin works just as well. And you know the silicone that comes on the end of the bobby pins that keep you from stabbing your head? Well, I took those off. So what you do, so the cylinder will fit over, you feed your hair through here, through the bobby pin, just like this. Feed it all down through the bottom and hold it just like this. Then you want to make sure your bobby pin is shut. You want to, now I'm looking in a mirror to the side, so hopefully you guys can see. You want to feed this cylinder right over both ends of the bobby pin. I'm going to try to see if I can see what I'm doing here. You know, everything's backward in the mirror, so, and when you're trying to do it on camera, and nothing works as well. and I don't want to do this take 100 times, so hopefully I can feed this in. So you want to make sure that your bobby pin here is laying flat, the sides together. And you want to slide, and you know, anything, when I have nails, everything's twice as hard. So, one second here, you want to make sure that you feed this cylinder, like I said, over both ends of the bobby pin, like this. So if you can see that, I have my cylinder fed through over both ends, right like this. And you want to feed it right over. Hang on one second, my phone is ringing. Alright guys, I'm back. So let's just start over with this piece. So sorry, my phone was ringing, I had to grab it. The weather is really bad here. They're calling for like 6 to 9 inches of snow. And so I had to grab that. Okay, so what you do, like I said, is pick a piece of hair up like this. Take your bobby pin, slide it through. I know I already showed this to you guys, but I'm gonna show it to you again. Feed your hair through. Hold on one second. Sorry, my son's in the other room playing on his Xbox and he's being all loud and the cat opened the door. So, then you're going to hold the bobby pin like this. And feed, make sure that you take the cylinder over both ends of the bobby pin. So you want to make sure that that's laying tight like this. Take the cylinder over both ends. Sometimes it's a little hard to get on, but and of course on camera when you're trying to get something to go right, it never does. So, see if you can see. So if you guys can see, I have the cylinder fed over both ends of the bobby pin. And just pull it over. Just like this. And you have the cylinder fed through. So, if you can see the cylinder there and my hair fed through, then you're going to take, like I said, they have these in bundles where you don't have to do this individually. You're just going to feed the feather through like that. Feed another feather through. If I'd hold one to it closer, it might work better. I know you guys probably can't see what I'm doing, but you get the gist of it. Feed that feather through. Then you're going to take your needle nose pliers, clamp, the clamp down flat. If you want to give it another clamp, just to make sure that it's down snug, because that's a little loose because it slipped. You know what? I give up. There. It's nice and tight. So now I have my two feathers that I fed through the little cylinder and my hair. You can see it hanging down like that. Then all you do is, so you can see it hanging down here, and like I told you guys, you know, you can see it right here, My feathers are about the color of my hair, so unfortunately it doesn't show up really good in this light. My nose is itching, but you can see it here. It kind of peeks out through the bottom. And then you can see them over on this side. And then when I style my hair, they all hang out. So, that was a feather extension video. I've shot it like 3 different times, and you know, it is what it is. I don't feel like shooting it again. I haven't felt good. I'm just finally starting to feel better. Not that you guys want to hear me moan and groan. So, that's a feather extension video. Like I said, I have some more on order, and I will do another one showing you the colored ones. They show up a little better. Hopefully, they'll show up a little better. I'm sure pink's going to show up a lot better than caramel. So, as always, comment, rate, and subscribe if you haven't done so already. And I will see you guys in the next video. Talk to you soon, guys.